tell people about Christ, the reason they don't is because they don't really believe in Christ. A convicted criminal once in England made the statement that if what the Bible states concerning hell was real, he would feel compelled to crawl across the whole breadth of England on his hands and knees to reach one person for Christ, to tell them about what was coming and to point them to Christ. If we truly believe the Bible knew what was coming, how much more we would reach out and try to win the lost of Christ? How much more will we find ourselves in the category of those in the book of Jude who with fear reached out, plucking from the flames of fire those who are on their path? Perhaps we need to get a greater vision of who Christ is, because that's what Christianity is all about. We call it serving God, but coming in church every week is not just serving God. It is telling others about Christ and building the kingdom of God. The Son of God did not come to sit in the synagogue every week and learn the scriptures. The Son of God came to seek and save that which is lost. How much more is that our responsibility? We know that every individual has a light pointing them to God, and that there is coming a judgment day when they will be judged by what they know. But it's our responsibility to reach out and inform them of what Scripture states, that they may join us in this relationship that we have with God, that they may know Him like no one else has ever known, in newness in life. Does anybody have any thoughts, any questions, anything they want to ask? If not, let's bow our heads and prepare our hearts for service. Gracious Heavenly Father, we give you all praise and glory for everything you've done for us and shall continue to do. Lord, we thank you that you're God who reigns on high and that there's none like you, Lord. I pray, Lord, that we just have a new vision of you today, Lord. Not that there's anything new under the sun, Lord, but that we may see you like we've never seen you before, Lord. That we may see you as Isaiah saw you, high and lifted up where you're trained for the temple, Lord. But may we have a burden for the lost before it's too late. Lord, we know that no one's left without an excuse when it comes to their judgment day. When each one of us die, we'll be held accountable for this life if we have not accepted you as our personal Savior. May we have a greater desire to reach lost like never before. Anoint the pastor as he brings forth the word today. Anoint his mind and his lips bring forth your word. Anoint the song leader and the musicians as they guide us in the songs you have us to sing, Lord. As they lead us upon their stringed instruments in the vocal cords, Lord. As they worship you, give them a special blessing as well. I pray, Lord, that our hearts and our minds will be good soil, Lord, for your word to fall on. That we may remember throughout the week, Lord. Greater than that, that we may apply it to our lives. That we would be even more transformed into your very image. Right now, Lord, we bind together and rebuke every attack of the enemy that should come our way. We pray that you set your angels at the four corners of the property above and below, that we may worship you in sincerity and truth, that the Holy Ghost may move as he so desires, making himself visible if he so chooses, Lord. We ask all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.